Okay, hi people. We are doing some stamp choice and envelope decoration today. I'm gonna show you what you can do with stamps. These are all stamps that are not currently offered at a post office. They are stamps that have been issued some years ago. I got them at the Regional Assembly of Texas. They actually have little packages if you don't want to do any math or you're kind of on the go. And they make little packages with the right amount of value that you need to send mail to each destination, whether it be Canada, USA, or international. This, of course, is for a postcard or a letter under 30 grams. If it's bigger than that, like if your letter has 10 pages, it might need some more postage, so have it weighed if you're not sure. So they have 90 cents for Canadian, $1.27 for USA, and $2.65 for international. That is, of course, Canadian currency. But I'm not just gonna take, and I have my three letters that I wrote at the Letter Writing Club at the Regional Assembly of Texas. It was on April 4th, so 2 weeks ago. 2 weeks already! Come on, I need to send this mail. I could have just taken the contents. I have a letter that goes to each destination. Canada, Levy, my hometown. United States, Philadelphia. And international, France. So I could have just taken the contents of each envelope and just put, you know, put the stamps that were in, like the Canadian envelope had 90 cents worth of stamps. I could have just used that on the Canadian envelope. Same for US and international. But of course, I'm not gonna do the simple thing, because some of the stamps that I wanted to put on the international envelope were in another envelope. I wanted to mix them up, arrange them around. I thought this stamp goes better with this person's personality or with this envelope color or design. I'm listening to the hockey on the radio. Jets are up 2-0 against St. Louis Blues, but it's the intermission, so we can just put some background music, because otherwise it's kind of distracting. Okay, so here you go. Yeah, I wanted to use that stamp for my friend in France. So let's start with the simpler one, the Canadian one. So 90 cents. It can be a couple cents more, but it cannot be a couple cents less. It's got to be 90 cents or more. I thought this one looked good because it's yellow. There's kind of like yellowish orange here. The bird, you know, it's going to a place where it's still cold right now. So we're gonna use the calculator here. If this phone doesn't fucking die. So we're gonna use the calculator here. We need 90 cents. What? Why is there four? Hello? I'm like, shut up. Why can't you take that out? Okay, so we start with 90 cents. I've already got the butterfly, that's 37. Okay, so we still need 53 cents minus a little bird, that's 10 cents. 43, if I put this one, what do we got? I got a Manitoba stamp that I'm keeping for one of my Winnipeg friends, not sure which one. I have a few. Okay, so 43. This is too much, 76. That's 30. Look, I could put a 30. Maybe this one. Yeah, my friend liked this one better because it kind of looks like a sports logo. My friend Eric is more into sports. He's not really into postage. You know, some other people will appreciate this one more. They'll know what it is. He's gonna look at that. It's not gonna ring a bell. So yeah, I mean, I got 47. So it's okay. I'm over 4 cents, that's fine. So I'll just maybe shuffle them around like that. Okay, this one's ready. Now for the American one, that's 127. Okay, look at the train, how cool it is. Like, you can actually make a train. I wish I had more cars, you know, to make a longer train. That's pretty cool. I think it goes well with the colors. Is it too dark in here? Or is it the fucking, like, the screen that makes it? I don't know. Okay, so this is going to Philadelphia. So we've got the train. So we've got 64 and 37. So we're missing 26 cents. I would like to use this one because I think that person would like it. 11 cents left. Okay, I got a 5 here. I kind of wanted to use this one, but it's 32. So 5, huh. Or I got here, I got a 15 here. Does it match? Yeah. Yeah, so, you know, again, I'm 4 cents over. It's okay. I'm not gonna fuss for 4 cents. Okay, and now this one. $2.65. It's expensive to send mail internationally, people. So if you're getting pen pals and you're new to it and you don't have a lot of money, it's so cool to write to people in other countries. It's really precious to me when I get a letter from my friend Mel in Australia or my friend Katie in England or my friends in France. It's so fucking cool. In Japan, I'm like, wow, you know, it's very special. But if you have a limited budget, you might want to try to write to people in your country or your continent, because you can write to more people, get more mail. So $2.65. I absolutely wanted to send this one to this person. When I saw that stamp, I was like, okay, that's going to her. That's only 8 cents. The bear, 76. Okay, I like this one. That's 4 cents. You know, so that's gonna take a lot of stamps. You've got two similar ones, so I'm not gonna use both of them. You know, so this one's 30. And the color, I think the color fits more like with this. It's kind of purplish. Still missing $1.47. I could use this one because it's kind of reminiscent of that color. Although it's kind of boring, but still missing $1.17. Am I gonna? This one doesn't fit because, you know, these are tones of green and earth colors, and it doesn't really go with anything. And it's blue, you know. Well, there is a green stamp here, but it's not. If there was, if the design of the stamp was more similar, I might have used it. But because it's very fine and this one is more gross, I'm not gonna use that one. It just doesn't fit. You can always go buy stamps, you know, at the post office. Not these ones, and not that either, because it doesn't fit. Although I could use a queen, we'd be 90 cents off. Am I gonna? Yeah, I think I, because there is like some black and white. So yeah, okay, one queen. But it, because remember your return address. So the queen might go there, and you have to address the postcard. The queen might be here. You can put some stuff here. You can put some stuff here. Remember, destination, return address. Yeah. So the queen is here. We need 27. I mean, I could use this one, but there's already one there, so no. 22. Okay, a 22 and a 5. Look, I have a nice 5 here. Can I move them closer together? Or can I move one? No, that doesn't work. It's not easy. You got the queen here. We have this one here. No, the address is right there. So, oh my god, no, not enough space! Queen! The butterfly! I mean, don't you think butterflies should be on top? Because they're flying. Yeah, okay. The queen here. Right. And how much are we now? What's that? Oh, come on. Okay. 90, 30, 76, 30, 8, 4, 22, Five. You're just good to go. Yeah. So that was fun, wasn't it? And now I just need to address them. Oh, man. I don't know how some of this glue is, but whoa. I'm kind of afraid to die like Susan in Seinfeld by licking stamps. Yeah, when you buy stamps at the post office nowadays, except the small denominations, they're mostly sticker stamps. You just stick them on, but you don't need to lick the stamps anymore. But yeah, these old ones, you need to. You can use tap water instead. Here you go, ready to go? That still needs the Vancouver Skyline seal on each one of the stamps. Or, you know, touch two. Just make sure every stamp postmarked. It's a very busy envelope. It's got everything it needs. Return address, destination address, and all the stamps. Try to not get any scotch tape on the stamps, and don't overlap the stamps, and don't overlap anything over the stamps. Well, this is just a corner, this is fine, but yeah. Otherwise, you're invalidating your stamp. And it's like it has no value anymore. Look, I'm gonna get creative here. You don't have to use a boring blank sticker, you know? Here's a picture of Vancouver. So why not use it? This is interesting. Look. There you go. All right. We're done. Woo!